Harmony Korine's new film Spring Breakers is his only even remotely accessible movie so far, but it will still polarize audiences. The film dares you to hate it through repetition, grainy video, and seemingly vapid lead characters, but it has a strangely hypnotic draw. While it would be easy to call Spring Breakers the ultimate example of style over substance, the initially simple story complicates as the film goes on in original and intriguing ways. The film follows four barely clothed college girls, played by Selena Gomez, Vanessa Hudgens, Ashley Benson, and the director's wife, Rachel Korine. The camera lingers over their bodies in a leering way at pretty much all times. It's creepy for sure, and creepier still is the way Korine's film shows the body of his wife more explicitly than the other girls. The movie has a rare R18 certificate in Australia, and it earns it. Strapped for cash and desperate for a way to escape after a term of dull classes, the girls paint water guns black, put on balaclavas, but not trousers, and rob a diner. The money allows them to travel to Florida for spring break. Selena Gomez's character, Faith, is not involved in the robbery, but joins in on the drugs and partying despite her religious background. She plays an interesting role in the film, as the sole voice of reason, and her actions alter the course of the film in an exciting way. She's symbolic of the group's grip on reality. Spring Breakers is very music-focused, and the soundtrack is a collaboration by Cliff Martinez, who scored Drive, and dubstep icon Skrillex. His well-known anthem Scary Monsters and Nice Sprites opens the film and sets the partying tone immediately. The movie closes with a truly beautiful string version of that same song. The film is also edited like a piece of dance music. Lines and conversations are repeated over and over like loops replaying in a club song. I suspect some will find the technique frustrating, but there's a point to all of this. The same footage of bikini-clad, drug-fueled, alcohol-soaked bodies dancing on the beach is repeated time after time as the idea of a spring break party changes from a perfect escape to dull routine in the eyes of the characters. These images become droning by design as the girls instead turn to a more dangerous kind of fun. Arrested on charges unrelated to the robbery, the girls are bailed out by a greasy, dreadlocked rapper calling himself Alien, played perfectly by a nearly unrecognizable James Franco. With jewelry across his teeth and giant dollar sign rims on his sports car, he's so well equipped that the girls flock to him despite the danger. He's into drugs and guns and isn't friendly with local gangs. The girl's relationship with him is one of the more interesting ideas in the movie, and we're never quite sure how much of his nonsense they're buying into. During a scene where Alien plays a white grand piano by the pool, surrounded by girls in pink balaclavas pirouetting around him with shotguns and AK-47s while they all sing a Britney Spears song, I realized that Spring Breakers is a near unmissable spectacle. Whether the film style frustrates you or not, there are things here that you just won't see done in any other movie. It's never anything but frank about its own astounding sleaziness, and it follows its ideas through to their conclusion where more audience-conscious films would have wimped out. I really enjoyed this one.